Roy. Roy's just bad.
Yeah. Dude, Roy's gimmick. I'm Marth, I think. Wait, no. No, not quite. It's a pretty good gimmick. Bethel!
So we've got Corrin and Wario.
The side Bs, man. I can imagine this matchup is very frustrating for Wario.
Because, again, it's a similar thing that was with Cloud.
Hey. Oh,
got big hitboxes all up in your face. And he said that Corrin is very slightly less tough than Cloud.
But he still struggles for the same thing.
Yeah, but it's the same reasons. Swords.
Swords, and they're fast.
Swords give characters like Wario, even a lot of other characters that are generally considered higher on the tier list, like Mario. Mario has a little bit of a harder time.
I do recall Coco having that period where if you went Marth, you got a free win on him.
Man, why didn't I play Marth during that time?
I know, right? Free wins on Coco. But, I mean, going back to the matchup, it seems like it's working exactly as you said. He's spacing out with these aerials, with these side Bs, and there's not really much Wario can do to fight against that aside from his own bike, which isn't
Ooh,
helping out that much.
That was really
I like
cool.
That. Almost
that was good
shield.
That was good shield pressure.
Definitely great
well,
shield.
Yep, very good dare to waft.
Beautifully done.
Like he told me, he's just going to run around and try not to die until he gets waft. Which, that back air is ridiculous.
Back air is incredibly strong.
That is so big, too.
I remember playing, I played in friendlies against Funker Monster, who went Corrin. That back air was the thing that took my socks.
That's really cool.
It's a good move.
it's a really big move.
It's also not bad for recovering, either, if you're facing the stage.
No, yeah, because it pushes you.
Which is, it's an interesting property to have. So back to the match that we can
yeah,
just see.
No, like actually,
the struggle.
Yeah, the real struggle is that Spearwing is just able to put these hitboxes out here, and there's nothing really that Austin can do to.
And if you whiffing the move doesn't really matter too much. The end bike is very low on them, so this big hitbox is coming with very big damage.
It's low risk, high reward.
Yeah. So it's definitely a very scary matchup for Wario.
Ooh, he grabbed. He was close enough to the Corrin that when Corrin... Wow.
Ooh!
That was dumb.
That was
but
slick.
That last stock was definitely less close than the first stock looked.
Well, it looks like if Spearwing can get Wario without a jump above her...
As is, like, free damage, like
exactly.
A bunch of it.
And then he has to eventually fade to a ledge and escape. And that's how that usually goes. All right. You're going to be going into game two. Not really much you can change about your game plan there if you're lofty. Because, I mean, Corrin hits you, you got to get away.
Yep. And if Corrin hits you, they might hit you again.
Now, I've seen from Wario, Wario doesn't really have too strong of a ground game, does he?
No, Wario is definitely the kind of character that's going to jump around a lot and try to hit you in the air, because think of his ground moves. Can you remember what they all look like? No, you can't.
I know
because you don't see them
that often.
A punch
or something?
There's a punch. There's like a thing where he does.
I like the down tilt.
The dash attack?
Horrible. Dash attack's cool. And so that's about all I remember. So
I
see what you're saying.
Tell me what Wario's F tilt looks like. You can't.
I don't know.
You've never seen that move.
So I can totally understand what you're saying then. And it seems like good bike, good grabs, good aerials. And
yeah.
If you let Corrin get away
from
you,
good.
That was a nice string.
He caught the pin with the grab and tried to back air the pin as Spearwing was trying to pin back on stage. But pin comes out too fast, man.
Frame four.
It's too quick.
Frame four if you do the instant pin.
That's dumb.
I mean, it's a movement tool.
It's dumb. This character's dumb.
What? No. Anyway, honestly, pretty close game. If I was in Wafty, I mean, you can see what Wafty's doing, too. He's slowly moving in and trying to get the Corrin to essentially corner themselves, right? Because if they corner themselves, then it's a little easier to get in.
Yeah,
however, he's about to lose percent lead.
Yeah, it's definitely a rough life here for Wario.
It's a hard
No, that's not going to kill. Corrin's kill throw actually looking more deadly than it really is.
Well, she has two as well. She has up throw. Ooh, that was a really good waft.
Beautifully done.
She has the up throw, of course, which sends straight off the top, and the down throw, which can send at the top or off the top and the side. So you can use down throw when you're closer to ledge, up throw mid stage.
But even still, they don't necessarily kill at like early percents.
No, they don't kill,
but they kill at like
it's closer to Marth's up throw.
Yeah, I would say it's comparable to Marth's up throw. Although in the scenario that he used it, Marth's up throw actually would have killed.
Really?
Yeah, because Waftu was like 120, and so was Corrin.
Oh, the
with
rage.
With rage, Marth's up throw definitely way better with rage.
It's still comparable, though. And I do like that recovery option from Waftu, not even needing to upbeat to grab ledge.
Yeah, he got out of the way because he knew that pin was coming, and he just decided he didn't want to deal with it.
I do like the way Wafty's jumping around him, using this bike to say, hey, I'm going to put some pressure down.
Yeah, he's definitely trying to counteract.
Ooh, he tried to beat out that. That's a... no!
That was
okay.
Oh, that was actually a really good counter.
That scared me, dude. That
okay, really Korn's counter is not that good. It's good, but
pre-patch.
It's not that good.
Get those pre-patch
Pre-patch that might have killed, yo. For real.
Do you remember the For Glory days where, like, people would stand completely still on For Glory with Korn? And then someone like walk up and fully charge a smash attack, and you'd counter last second.
Yeah, that's a dope strat.
That was the For Glory strat for the longest time.
That almost
Corrin.
Killed.
Let's pretend you were AFK.
Oh, he tried to do it,
but does have invuln frames.
Yeah, invulnerability on startup, which is really dumb, and I hate it. It makes me so mad every time.
Are you sure it was Wafty who was doing that angry Twitter rant about Corrin and not you?
Okay, no. I will complain about Corrin later, but on the real, that move having invulnerability on startup is ridiculous.
And then afterwards, her wings are also invulned.
Yeah, that's dumb. You gotta hit her head.
A few frames, and you have to hit her head.
Okay. Oh, that one actually killed.
Like I said, down throw is better for killing off the side. Maybe he thought he was going to DI it bad. And get a kill, like DI straight to the right, and that's why down through. But up throw will kill around the same percent as Marth's.
Yeah, that definitely would have been the percent that with rage, I would have been looking if I was playing Marth.
Yeah, you're looking for the exact same thing
for an up throw, because at that point the only things that are going to kill are going to be like a tip or aerial.
Yep.
Or an up throw.
Or a smash attack.
Let's be real, you're not hitting anybody with a smash attack at 130.
You'd be surprised on ledge catching a ledge option. That's your best bet.
That's the For Glory.
Catching like a roll or standard get up?
But
catching a two frame?
No, just F smashing at the ledge. F smashing with the ledge.
F smash over and over until it hits. There we go.
Yeah, that's the For Glory.
The strats for nibs.
So speaking of For Glory, we only play on one stage here too, only our stage is Smash.
We just occasionally have a platform that comes in. Gotta say though,
Wafty keeping it close. I'm just alternating between Austin and Wafty. I think he abandoned the Wafty tag, but
Austin
everyone still calls him that anyway. Keeping it closer.
I guess he expected maybe a fastball or something to try to catch up with the neutral B. Corrin's neutral B is an incredibly powerful tool that I'm not seeing Corrin. I'm not seeing Sphere Ring utilize.
Mostly probably because he can just get by on using all of his other moves and doesn't really see a great use for it at this time.
I suppose, yeah.
I mean, he's been winning all the games.
And Wafty is forced to approach him, so he can just keep waiting for Wafty approaches and just out-aerial him, which it seems like it's working quite well.
I mean, it's kind of the strategy that you want to do when you're playing this like aerial floaty character as a sword character. It's the same strategy as, again, going back to something that I know, Marth versus Yoshi. You just want to put up those aerials and prevent them from getting in.
Makes sense.
And that's what makes it really hard.
Ooh!
With the exception of getting that down air to waft.
Down air to waft. Three games in a row, but it hasn't... I mean, he's been up stocks multiple times, but it doesn't seem like it really matters in this matchup. I feel like Corrin can...
Corrin doesn't really
stock pretty fast.
Corrin doesn't really like. I mean, for one, Wario doesn't really rage anybody out. It's not like Mario or Falcon or anything like that, where they'll just like rage you out. And Corrin kind of can kill at just about any percent. Corrin doesn't really need rage or anything like that. Wow, that was dumb.
I didn't think that was gonna work. That was definitely well done from Wafty, if that was expected.
Kick into my mouth. You won't.
So at this point, Wofty doing a really good job.
Yeah, he's he's keeping it together way more than he was previously. Holding a lead a lot longer than he did for the previous two games, because both games he got the first stock.
And he knows he's ahead right now, too. He knows he's ahead. He knows he's probably going to lose that stock soon. So he's going for very, very safe damage and pokes. But getting in on this Corrin is proven to be very difficult. Air dodging through the attacks just to have to air dodge again as another attack is coming out.
Oh, the Corrin down air. The so bad it's good.
Ooh, I was expecting the kick in the direction. But lucky that Wofty wasn't.
That Nair almost killed him. He's at 190, which, okay, he's actually... He's super dead.
He vanished.
Yeah, he got evaporated.
So Wofty still has this game.
Yeah, he's got a noticeable lead.
The last Woft came out approximately a minute ago now, so in about 30 seconds we should see that other Woft come out.
He might go for a haft. Or a half.
Very true, and he should have a half waft by now too.
Oh, okay, for a second, that was a scary for a second, I thought he upbeat instead of jumped off the bike, and I'm like, is he just gonna? Kill
and him there something? Is the full waft. Don't need to play with that half waft, but
he wasted
will
it.
Not take it.
You can't go out with Corrin like that.
Yeah, he tried to beat Corrin's upbeat, and that unfortunately is not a thing that's going to happen. I feel like he could have gotten better punish out of that. That. Missed counter, but with all the stress of the moment, Corrin being at 130, he just wanted her off stage. Most of the cast, especially sword fighters, you get him off stage, and a Gimp is a little easier. With Corrin, Gimping is actually quite difficult.
Gimping Corrin's really hard. you gotta. I mean, you saw the Usam vid about, like, you know, how you can Gimp Corrin. Like, the fact that somebody had to make that vid.
I actually still haven't seen that. I mean,
it's like basically you like fall down with like a persistent hitbox and you like hit Corrin's head.
And don't get hit by the wings because the wings are really big.
I mean, it doesn't matter if you trade with the wings, but as long as you hit the head.
That's the thing. It's the angle she sends at. Her wings cover her pretty well. Ooh, that was a fantastic back air from Wofty.
That was a European back air.
Yes.
It was a Nice back air. Get it? Because the French city of Nice.
Oh.
It's spelled N-I-C-E like nice.
That's
a good joke.
That's a cute joke you get there, fam. I gotta say, I don't know if you ever heard of a warrior main from, I believe, what region is it? Jeez. Well, that's gonna make it a little difficult. It is a warrior main in a European country. I can't remember.
Good job.
I'm sorry.
There's a lot. We're here on Town and City. That was a pretty close game, but Austin kept it together. He simply held the lead that he had, and, you know, it persisted. Now, when he wasted the waft, I was actually a little concerned that was it.
I mean, the percent lead was still fantastic.
Yeah, but even still, Corrin, unlike Wario, benefits immensely from Rage.
Yes.
Because the kill moves that she already has become even killy.
Woo! That was scary. If he had jumped from ledge there or did a standing get up, he was impaled. So use of neutral B in this matchup, I feel like that's something to discuss with Austin. I like them a lot. He's throwing them out at the right times. He's covering a lot of options.
Bite?
Yeah. Covering a lot of options with it and just playing really well about it. Also, I noticed that he's air dodging through the up B most of the time instead of trying to challenge it like most players would. He knows that it's a scary thing. He knows he can't really punish it.
Yeah, it's really hard. Good job. Follows up the down air.
Ooh, I like that throw.
Grabs him again. Ooh. Hits him with the bike. Doesn't go for any sorts of follow-ups.
No, but he's definitely playing neutral fantastic right now.
Yeah, he's winning pretty heavily. Now, the only issue here is that Corrin could actually kill with, like...
A tip or F smash would do it. A side B would kill even earlier. But that backer will not take it, unfortunately. Looks like Wario might be trying to build up a little bit of waft too when he gets a chance, eating the bike parts, get a little bit of health back in the process.
If downer doesn't kill off the side on its own.
Yeah, of course.
Which it can...
Ooh, oh! That could have been a punish, but he whiffed the grab and fell through. So.
That was a depressing whiff.
Something a lot of people forget Wario can do, including myself just now. He can totally get back on that bike.
Really?
And that caught spearing off pretty hard.
That's silly. But Austin getting the first... Austin K, a.k.a. Wofty, a.k.a. Wario.
Should have just held him there.
It's like, let's go. gonna go for a ride. Wonder if he could have like, if he could have held onto him for long enough to
back throw.
Would that have worked? Would that
maybe
have worked?
It depends how fast he can move. Because would it have killed? Yeah. Would he have lived? I don't know. Maybe.
So, also making a good use of the quality that he's had during all of these games, which was his ability to take the first stock.
Yes. And he has the waft right now, too. And if he dies with it, he still keeps it, which is why he's holding onto it so dearly.
Yeah. If he can actually probably kill if he comboed
into
waft.
He's in 10% right now. Like, yeah. Sheik will die. She
you got, you got characters on the brain that are not on the screen.
I want to say she. There's an extra k sound.
Well, I
want to
play she.
It's like he's not even here, bro.
Dude, it's all right. That means me and you are the best.
Yeah. Not Alex Stroder's here. Nah, he got back on the fight.
Oh! Trying to challenge the upbeat again. That is invuln. It's not
just but the back
hit,
air.
But that back air.
Let's go, boys.
We'll take the game. A 2 stock.
The Paul Walker? Yo, let's go, Robin.
So the first two matches looked very in Spearwing's favor. You saw why he hated the matchup. Second two matches looked like
he was playing it very
doing a good job.
Very patiently.
Playing extremely well too.
He got the lead and he just held it.
But I wonder how he's going to perform against a character like Robin.
Yeah, this is an entirely different matchup. I would imagine. I don't know how. Because, of course, these are Tucson boys. They play a lot more often than we get to see.
Very true, very true.
So they actually probably know a thing or two about each other's habits.
I will say one thing, though. I always felt myself that the person who swapped characters is at advantage if they're able to swap their playstyle quickly.
Because if they're proficient at switching between those two characters, you may be an advantage.
Just because it can mess up the opponent. Now the opponent has to completely rework all their downloads on you, whereas if they're still playing the same character, anything you've learned from the previous matches is still there. That's just my own opinion on it, though.
There's validity in the thought, because obviously if somebody is used to fighting one character in one playstyle, suddenly switching that up mid-set could potentially give you somewhat of an edge.
And you still have the knowledge from the previous games on their character, so if they're still going for similar setups and they're not adapting well, then you can definitely capitalize. But that is not the case right now.
We still got a really close game, mostly probably because he's good at fighting both the Korin and the
because he's gotten practice in both, which definitely helps. Caught the book again. Yeah.
The mix up, the character mix up, doesn't mean as much when you play this dude all the time.
And the checkmate.
Which I don't know if they play. I don't know if they play all the time or if they play frequently.
They play. We know they play.
They live in the same city.
That's good enough for us. We're just Phoenix boys. What do we know?
Yeah, ignorant Phoenix boys.
Got the loft on deck. Probably doesn't want to waste it just now, though. Wants to get the kill if he can without it. But if he's pushed to, he might have to.
Yeah, I would say he's probably in a position where he could get the kill while retaining the loft. Then try to keep that to get an early kill on the second stock. Simply because, you know, if you have a really good kill move, why would you blow that on the first stock?
It's kind of like
when you're at game 5.
Little max KO punch if he could hold it. Which he really can.
Yeah. Rip Mac. Every other character with like that charge up like super move, they can hold it. Except Mac.
I guess
he gets the KO.
And he still has the waft.
He still has the waft, so
a pretty good spot, actually.
It's actually really dangerous. However, Robin is heavier than Korin, right?
I don't think so, actually.
Really?
I think Robin is lighter than Korin.
That'd be dumb.
Yep, no, I believe I can look it up real fast while we're playing. While we're watching.
Ooh. Tries to bite him, but eats a Levin sword instead. Yo, is it coming? Okay. For real, I thought it was coming. This is dangerous percent for them both. Because if Spearwing can win neutral just like one or two more times.
He gets a throw into an up air and takes
the game. Just one more time, I guess. Go ahead and make me look like an idiot with your super strong up air. But that was a really close game 5. Good job to Spearwing with the character mix-up. Good job to Austin for bringing that back.
Corrin is heavier by 3 units.
Making Spearwing switch off the Corrin, which I think is definitely something to note. So,
but yeah, so that is pretty scary. Robin is lighter than Corrin by about 3 weight.
That's really dumb.
3 weight.
As a matter of fact, that's really dumb.
Which means Corrin lives approximately 15% longer.
Ugh. I don't want that character to live any longer.
Dude, don't worry about it.
I didn't even play Corrin's Fire Emblem games. I actually have never played a Fire Emblem game. I play Marth, but I've never played a Fire Emblem game. Much like everyone who has ever played Marth in Smash. Nobody who actually like is into Fire Emblem plays Marth in Smash.
Yeah. Yeah. Spearwing doesn't play Marth.
Yeah.
At least he plays a Fire Emblem.
He plays